Hey guys, my name is Cam and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So as you can tell by the title of this video, we're going to be doing something I've never done before, which is pretty much just showing my entire K-pop photo card collection. So if you've watched any of my previous videos, you know that my collection is separated into my Seulgi binder, who's my ultimate bias, and then my really bad boy binder, which contains other groups like Stray Kids, ITZY, and IZ*ONE. I'm gonna stop rambling and let's get into the video. So we're gonna start off with my RBB binder, which I have made some changes in since my last organization video. So on this first page, we just have my really, really small Irene collection. I have decided to collect a few of her photo cards, just maybe one or two per era. So I'm going to have her in the front of this binder. But for now, we only have one of her RBB photo cards and one of her finale scrapbook version photo cards. And I did used to have a few more of her finale cards, but I did decide to sell them to downsize my Irene collection since I didn't think that I needed all five of her cards. Next is my Stray Kids collection, and this is the only OT9 set that I decided to collect. And it's the mint green version of the High Stay Lucky Box photo cards. I am still missing Jisung's photo card, which does kind of bug me since it is the last photo card that I need, but it isn't at the top of my priorities right now. And now we get into my Bangchan collection, who's my ultimate male bias. So we have his two mixtape cards, the selfie and the making version, and then his I Am Not selfie photo card, his I Am Not baby photo card, his I Am Who making photo card, his I Am Who self-portrait photo card, which low-key kind of scares me, but anyways, we have the rest of his I Am Who photo cards, so the yellow, white, and black border photo cards, which were the hardest for me to find and are pretty expensive for all the members. Next, we have the I Am You photo cards, so the pre-order card, and then the three album photo cards, so the name version, the I Am You version, and then the pink border. And then I just decided to keep my Chan unit in the middle, which is the one with Hyunjin. Next, we have the mirror photo cards, so we have the limited, the red border, the black border, and the purple border. And Miro continues onto this page with his Clay 1 Miro version and his logo version photo card. And now we have his Yellowwood photo cards. So just his making, his two selfies, his black border, and his yellow border. And then on the bottom, we just have two of his Levanter cards. And Levanter continues onto this page with his selfie borderless card, his blue border, his behind version, and then his limited lenticular photo card. So as you can see, I only collect his album photo cards. I don't collect any of his non-album photo cards. And then I've made spaces for Stray Kids' newest album, Go, which did arrive in the mail today. And then all alone on this page is his Levanter broadcast card, which was kind of an impulsive purchase, and I am thinking about selling it, but for now, it'll stay on this page. And then on this final page of Chan, we just have one of his I Am Who pre-order benefits, his pink Polaroid from I Am You, and then one of the merch Polaroids from one of their concerts. So that was the end of Chan, and now we get into my Yena collection. And I have decided to sell or trade off all of these photo cards since IZ*ONE just has too many cards with their albums for me to keep up with them. It's just gotten way too expensive and hard to find trades. So if you're interested in any of my Yena or IZ*ONE cards, please DM me on Instagram at zimzillabear. I'd love to trade for some Irene or Red Velvet cards, so yeah. But anyways, I do have two out of the three photo cards for Color Eyes, so her selfie and then her unit with Taewon. And then her four Heart Eyes cards, so the two from the Violetta version and then the two from Sapphire version. And then we get into Bloom Eyes, which was the era that made me start to regret or question me collecting IZ*ONE. But we have three of her I Was version photo cards. And then I have one of her I Am version photo cards, and then all four of her I Will version photo cards. And I have to say that I Will is my favorite set, so that's why I collected all four of them. Next, we have one of her IZ*ONE cards, which is from the I Will version, and then two out of her three AR photo cards. I was never able to find this AR card, which was from the I Will version, and it was one of my favorites since it was a selfie version, but oh well, I guess it is what it is. And then I have Taewon and Yena's one day postcards from their photo book. I did used to collect Jo Yuri's, so Taewon, Yuri, and Yena, but then Bloom Eyes hit and I was like, never mind, I'll just collect Yena. And then their last comeback hit, and I was like, never mind, there's just too many cards. I'll just stop collecting IZ*ONE. But yeah, that's the end of my IZ*ONE collection. Next is my Lia collection, which is almost complete. So I have all six of her It's Icy photo cards. So her signature card, her pre-order card, her borderless selfie card, her blue border card, her Icy board, and her It's border card. And then we have It's Me, which is almost complete. I'm only missing two more of her cards. So we have her signature borderless card, her black border card, and then I'm missing her orange border card, but it is on the way. And I'm missing one of her units, which is the one with Yeji, but I have her unit with Ryujin, her Taeryang, and her Yuna unit. And then I have her two pre-order postcards from It's Icy, and then all three of her pre-order cards from It's Me. And then the final section of this binder are cards or goods that I'd like to sell or trade. I might have posted them, I might not have posted them, but if you see anything you'd like to buy or trade for, feel free to DM me on Instagram or Twitter, but I'll just do a quick flip through of these items. And I did used to collect Sana from Twice, but that too got out of hand with the photo cards. So that wraps up this binder, and now we'll get into my Seulgi binder. And now we have my biggest collection and my biggest joy. Oh, that was a pun. But it's my Seulgi collection. So I collect pretty much everything for her except for A4 photos and then the really rare lenticular photo cards. And there are a few gaps in my binder since a few of her items are really hard to find, but I am working on it. But I'll stop rambling and just show you what I have so far. So on the binder inside, we just have two of the Kashi wrappers from the Zimzalabim and Switzerland Kashi, and then one of the pictures of Seulgi that I cut out in my DIY phone case video, which if you haven't seen, you should definitely check out because it low-key flopped. But anyways, we'll get into the photo cards now. So we have her SumCoex fortune cookie card, her two school loss photo cards, which were definitely some of my grail cards and really, really hard for me to find. Next, we have her ice cream cake album photo card, the later version of this photo card, and then her Dum Dum photo card. And then on the bottom here, I left room for her Dum Dum stickers, which I do have, but I'm saving for a organization video. Next, we have her 2016 Seasons greeting set, and then her One of These Nights photo card from the album. And then we have her Russian Roulette cards, so the album photo card and then her two stickers. And then on the bottom here, we have her 2017 Seasons greeting set, and then I've left a space for her Smilebox 2018 photo card, which is definitely probably my biggest grail card right now. It's literally impossible to find anywhere. Impossible. Like, even if it was expensive, I would buy it. Like, I swear, this photo card is gonna be the death of me. Next is a pretty empty page, so we have her rookie photo cards, and then I've saved a space for her rookie stickers. And then we have a Red Summer row, so her two album photo cards, and then her sticker. And then on the bottom here, I've saved room for some of her rarer cards, so her Red Room collect book photo card, and then her third anniversary set. And I do have these, and they're gonna be in an upcoming organization video. The next page is pretty much a peekaboo page, so I've left room for her Shilla Duty cards, which this one is impossible to find. Impossible. But I do have this one coming in the mail. And then I have her two peekaboo album photo cards, her peekaboo Kashi, her collect book photo card, and then her paper folder photo card. And then I've left space for her 2018 season greeting set, which has been really impossible for me to find for some reason. Impossible. Even though it's a more recent one. Next, we have a nice and complete page. So we have her two Bad Boy album photo cards, her Bad Boy Kina photo card, which is probably one of my favorite photo cards of Seulgi, her normal Kina photo cards, her Bad Boy sticker, her Bad Boy hologram photo card, and then her Etude House card. And then on the corner here, I have her SM Town business card. So the next page is another one that's pretty empty, and hopefully I can fill it up soon, but we have her hashtag cookie jar album photo card, her SM Town live in Osaka photo card, and then her holographic Redmare photo card, which came with the sticker set. And then here's a row for her Redmare merch cards, and I do have her holographic wallet and voice keyring photo card on hand, but again, I'm saving it for an organization video. And then on the bottom here, I've saved room for her superstar cards, which I haven't been able to find for a good price. Next is a page for one of my favorite Red Velvet eras, which is Power Up. So I have her normal version photo card and then her two limited, so the selfie and the clear, and then the limited version standee here. Next, we have her two stickers, and I've saved a room for her Power Up Cashbee, and then her hologram card. The last photo card here is her Pantone Passport Wallet card, which is a photo of her in this era, but it's been really impossible for me to find for a good price, so... Impossible! Definitely another one of my priorities. Next is kind of a mixed page, so we have her two RBB photo cards and then her Cashbee and then her holographic card. Next, I've saved space for her iPhone case and her binder photo card, and I do have her iPhone case photo card on the way, but I haven't been able to find her binder photo card like at all, so I think it's gonna be pretty difficult for me to find. Next, we have her Sappy album photo card, and then I've saved a room for her Revel Love Baby wallet photo card, which, like the binder photo card, I've never been able to really find. And then on the corner here, we just have her Revelo fan club photo card. Next is my Zimzilla bin page, which is probably one of the prettiest pages in my binder since it's all complete and it's all one era. So we have her guidebook version photo card, and then her two day one version photo card, and then her day one Kino photo card, which is probably up there with the bad boy Kino photo card for one of my favorite Sugi cards. And honestly, Kinos are so useless, like I never use them, but the cards are so freaking cute. Like, that's really smart on SM's part to release those really cute cards with those useless Kino albums. But anyways, next we have her sticker set, her Cashbee, and then her trading cards. Then on this page, we have her Zimzilla Bim holographic card, and then I've saved room for her Time to Love Goods, and then her Pantone Zip Note photo card. And these three photo cards, like the other ones I'm missing, have been literally impossible for me to find. Impossible. Impossible. So if you see them, DM me. If you want to sell them, DM me. Literally, I really want to fill up those spaces. But anyways, next we have her day two photo cards. So her guidebook card, and then her two day two version photo cards. And I think this is probably one of my favorite album photo cards of Sugi. And then we have her day two Kino, and then her hologram card. Next is my LaRouche page, which has to be another one of my favorites in this binder. So we have all three of her member photo cards from the Fortune Scratch set, and then her collectbook photo card, her acrylic charm photo card, and then her keyring photo card. I always get these two confused, so hopefully I got it right, but if not, I probably corrected myself by now. And then on the bottom here, we just have her three Fortune Scratch cards. On this next page, we have her LaRouche hairpin photo card, her Switzerland Cashbee, and then her G Market gift card. And then we get into my finale photo card collection, which was definitely one of the hardest collections for me to complete. So we have her three scrapbook version photo cards, and I have to say that this is my favorite Sugi album photo card, like overall. Like, it's so beautiful, it's so iconic. Like, I know that scalpers are selling this card for like $50 or more, which is absolutely ridiculous. Like, it reminds me of the price range of Irene photo cards, which really shouldn't be a thing since the albums are only $20. Like, it's just an album card, bro. But anyways, for this next page, we continue her finale goods and pretty much finish up her photo cards. So we have her second sticker, her light projector keyring photo card, her hologram card, and then her lenticular card, and both of these came with the finale standee. And then on the bottom here, we just have her 2020 Seasons Greetings set. And I forgot to mention that I don't collect her Seasons Greetings pre-order benefits since they're not really official technically. Next are just a few album goods, so I just have her day one and day two ticket up here, her day one standee, and then her day two postcard. And then we have a finale album merch page, so the envelope and the postcard and the receipt. Now we'll get into the some coex merch, so like the 4x6 photos and postcards. So we have the automatic slash ice cream cake 4x6, and then the two, the velvet 4x6 photos. Next we have her Dum Dum Polaroids, and I am still missing her corresponding 4x6 photo. And then here's the page that I saved for her Russian Roulette Polaroids. And then next we have her Russian Roulette 4x6 set, and then her Rookie 4x6. Up here, I saved a space for her peekaboo 4x6 photo, and then I have her two red flavor 4x6 photos. On this next page, we have her summer magic 4x6 photo, and then her RBB 4x6 photo. And then again, I've saved a space for her bad boy 4x6 photo. And then the final page of 4x6 photos are from the Reva Festival series. So the finale, the day one, and the day two versions. And then on this page, I just have two of her Japanese postcards. So the hashtag cookie jar one, and then one of the savvy one. Next, we'll get into the postcard sets. So we have her ice cream cake set, her the velvet set, her Russian roulette set, her rookie set, her red flavor set, her red room set. Oh my God, I sound like a robot, but I saved a space for her the perfect velvet postcards, and then a space for her the perfect red velvet postcards, and then her summer magic postcards. Now we have her RBB postcard set, her red mirror postcard set, and then I decided to put the stickers here as well, her Zimzilla Bim postcard set, and then finally her finale set and her LaRouche set. And then on this one pocket page, I just have some stickers that don't fit in any other size sleeve. So I have her bad boy circle sticker and then her the velvet sticker set. Next, we have the standees that came with the hologram cards. So the summer magic one, the RBB one, the Zimzilla Bim one, the Oompa Oompa one, and the finale one. And then on this three pocket page, I just have her G-Market postcard, her red mirror film strip, and then her postcard that came with the organizer. And then the final official item in this binder is her G-Market large postcard. And then here are all of the unofficial photo cards that I have of Sulgi, which I received in trades or purchases. And then in the back sleeve, I just have the packaging that came with the hologram standees. So that was my mid-year photo card collection. I do have a few other photo cards from NCT, but I do keep them separately in my room. But anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I think it was really fun for me to see how much progress I've made over these last few months. If you saw any photo cards you might be interested in buying or trading for in this binder, feel free to DM me on Instagram at SimzillaBit. But as always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay loud, and I'll see you in my next video. Peace!